Evergreen Park.
The date is August 17, 1970, in the cramped studios of WCIU-TV, a small station with ethnic programming in Chicago. Former WVON radio DJ Don Cornelius begins a journey that will last 25 years. Urban Street celebrates 25 years of love, peace, and soul.
The idea was Don's idea. He and I got together and we had a production, you might say. We used local talent there in Chicago, from the Shylights to Gene Chandler to Jerry Butler, the Impressions, and on and on and on. And we would make three stops each Friday at various high schools. And it was called, and we promoted on the air as such, the Soul Train at 4 o'clock will be at Englewood High School. At 6:30, the Soul Train will make its second stop at Holland High School. And at 10 o'clock or 10:30, the Soul Train will make its final stop, and we'd name another high school. So each week on Fridays, that is what we would do, and we would promote on the air, and we'd have entertainers. So it really was like a mini concert is what it was.
He's had good support. The format was just right. Most TV things don't last that long. They last, 3 years? Record artists last 3 years, albums last 3 years, and it's gone.
Don Cornelius began his broadcast career as an announcer and part-time jock at the legendary radio station WVON.
The Black Giant.
WVON, Giant Sound of Soul.
I don't know if you've heard this story or not, but Roy Wood, who's now deceased, was news director for WVON Radio. And Roy was out in Chicago driving around, and I don't know if you or a great number of people know it, but Don Cornelius was a Chicago police officer. And Roy made a traffic violation, and he was pulled over by Don. And as Don approached the car, Roy presented his license, and Don is asking all of the questions that police officers usually do when you stop for a traffic violation. And Roy Wood commented on Don's voice and told him, said, gee, you know, you're in the wrong profession. You need to come by and see me. I'm over VON, so why don't you come by and do an audition tape? So Don took him up on that, and in all honesty, that is how Don was hired in broadcasting at WVON Radio.
I used to be at the station at VON day and night, whatever it was to do over there. I was over there doing it. If they had a commercial to read, I read that. If it was a talk show, I did that. If one of the regular jocks like Herb was off, I was like the resident swingman, and I got to do their show. And I realized that I was getting a little crazy, because it got to a point where when they got sick, when Herb or E-Rod, any one of those guys got sick, I would be hoping they didn't get well so I could keep doing this show. So I said, this is getting crazy. I need to do something.
And Don always wanted, even though he was in the news department, he always really wanted to be on air as a personality. And I love Don, and I thank him for everything he's done and keeping me a part of that program. But Don is not the best personality in the world as far as personality goes. A great guy, though, okay? But he wanted to be on the air, and Rodney Jones, who was program director, let him sit in sometimes when we go on vacation or off on sick leave and things like that. So Don, along with Roy Wood, had migrated from VON, although they were still a part of the radio station in the news department. They had gone on Channel 26, and they had a program called The Black's View of the News. And this would air during the evening drive newscast, sort of like opposite your network news program. And Don and Roy Wood actually anchored that particular newscast, and it was called just that, The Black's View of the News. So that was an intro for Don into television, I should say, locally there in Chicago.
During his tenure at WVON, Cornelius noticed a huge void in entertainment-targeted programs toward African-American audiences.
You know, I thought that it was, you know, that we should do some entertainment shows on, I mean, on television. I mean, the only opportunities we had on television is to sit around and talk about the man and how he was, you know, holding us down. We, you know, television is an entertainment medium, and it's probably one of the reasons Soul Train's been around as long as it has, is because we just deal with entertainment. We don't deal with social issues. We don't teach. We don't preach. We just do entertainment.
Legendary television band show premiered on Chicago's WCIU Channel 26 on August 17, 1970. It was an idea Don believed in right from the start.
I was already working there on a sort of a part-time basis on a show called The Black Field of News, and you know, Channel 26 was a station that was open to experiment, and they were willing to try things. And I got to know Howard Shapiro, who I guess is chairman now, and who was my boss, and a guy who took me under his wing. And then one day I said, hey, Howard, let me try this. And he said, it sounds stupid, but okay, let's try it.
We were in a financial building, the Board of Trade, doing a live show with young kids. We had some problems with it, but it was pretty good. And at one time, we had 80,000 kids who had signed up to dance on the show, and we figured if their parents knew when they were going to conceive and rode in before they were born, they could get on when they were 18 and dance. Everybody jumped in on it. Reverend Jackson found it exciting and used to come over regularly. And the male was very, very strong in the calls to dance. So it was obvious we had a lot of people watching.
That train, man, that did it. It really, there's no two ways about it. It was a hit on Channel 26 with Clinton Gent and Don Cornelius. And when they moved it to L.A., there wasn't a doubt in my mind that it would not persevere for years. I never thought about it ending. I still don't think about it ending, because it's the epitome of black music.
Who was the original voice saying the Soul Train? It was WVON good guy, Joe Cobb.
He had approached me about doing the commercials for the program, and I recall we were in the studio at the radio station, and he had the copy, and I was reading the copy for the program. The program was called Soul Train, and as I got to the point where Soul Train, I said, Channel 26, this Saturday, airing at whatever time, the Soul Train, and I just did it like that, and yeah, I did it as a joke, honestly. So Don was impressed with it. He said, I like that. Do that again for me.
Still to come, Chicago's Native Sons.
It's the sexiest song on your radio. Dance for Me by The Mark Williams.
Darling, you are all the woman that I need. Just look at you.
For Me, an intimate, modern, romantic love story set to a sophisticated old-school groove.
Do you know what really makes me happy? I love that when you dance. When you dance.
If you buy one download this year, make sure it's Dance For Me. Dance For Me, the sensual R&B smash from The Mark Williams on Master Sellers Music. Dance For Me, available for digital download on iTunes, Amazon, Google Music, CD Baby, and all streaming services.